Grand theft auto and a high-speed chase. Those are the elements that played out in court today, with the accused standing before a local judge. Today, News 3's Rachel Carden is getting a closer look at this case that included reports of a woman leaping for her life from a moving car.
We spoke exclusively to Terry Bly's grandmother today, just a few hours after he was arraigned in the Portsmouth courthouse. Now, police tell us this is where Bly crashed a car after being chased by police. They told us it all started because one woman made a phone call. A call to 911 from the side of Interstate 264.
It's a female walking on the right shoulder. She advised that she had to jump out of a vehicle at gunpoint.
A woman jumps out of a moving car, telling police she and another woman were abducted in Chesapeake, and her car was being driven by this man, 28-year-old Terry Bly. As police try to make a traffic stop, they said Bly sped off before crashing right here. New video shows Bly being taken into custody yesterday morning after running from the crashed car. Today, News 3 spoke to Bly's grandmother, Lily Street, who's having trouble believing what her grandson is behind bars for.
I think he might be with the wrong crowd because he's a very good boy. He's very good. And I'm just shocked.
Police say the other woman who was abducted was let out of the car early on. The second woman is the one who jumped from the 1997 black Lexus, the same car that knocked over this fence.
I really don't know what's going on. None of the family, all we know, he was in a police chase.
State police said alcohol and drugs were involved. Bly is now charged with abduction, running from the cops in the car and on foot, reckless driving, damaging property, traffic violations, and DUI. Some of these offenses seem off to his family.
He have been in and out of jail for a little trouble, but nothing like that. Abducting two women, that's unbelievable. I just can't, because he's a very nice looking young man. And to abduct two women, for what reason?
Police say Bly is familiar with his victims. Though the investigation is ongoing and state police can't answer all of our questions, they say they have no reason to believe the women were potential victims of human trafficking. They say Bly is not being cooperative, and more information will be provided at a later date. And we know Bly is expected back in court in July. In Portsmouth, I'm Rachel Carden, News 3.